In the previous video, you saw how you could import various formats as well as multi-channel files containing an embedded alpha channel. Depending on your background, you might want to edit in your other NLE and complete your program in Autodesk Smoke. If this is the case, then keep watching and I'll show you how to do a standard conform of your sequence. If you intend to do all your editing in Autodesk Smoke, then please skip to the next video about media organization in the media library. Whether you are working with Apple Final Cut Pro 7 or Apple Final Cut Pro 10, first you need to export an XML. If you're using Avid Media Composer, you need to export an AAF. Smoke supports both these formats and is able to rebuild the sequences from the other editing applications. With regards to media such as video sources, you may choose to work with the native media or cached intermediates coming from your other NLE. For example, you could have edited using Apple ProRes and now you want to edit with native R3D files. Or perhaps you consolidated and transcoded your original media to DNxHD and you want the choice to either use your original media or the DNxHD intermediates. The conforming tools in Smoke will give you all these choices when conforming your sequence. Let's focus on a basic conform example. You have been working in your other NLE and you have simply exported an AAF or XML. You've imported media from various locations on your drives and your network, but none of the media has been moved around. So this would be a typical job where everything is done on one workstation. In Smoke, you'll start off by switching to the Conform tab. This interface will eventually display your sequence at the bottom of the screen, and it will also display an event list containing every source clip used in the active sequence. To begin the process of importing your AAF or XML, go to the media library and choose a folder that you want your sequence to be located as it is imported. You can always move the sequence clip to another folder at a later time if desired. Right-click over the event list and you can choose to load a new XML or AAF file. In the browser, you can navigate to the folder location where you exported your AAF or XML. In my case, I exported an XML into a folder, and the media is located in the surrounding subfolders. Double-clicking on the XML file will bring up the preview player with relevant information such as format, resolution, and frame rate. Just a side note, when you import media into Smoke, you can choose to work with the native files or tell Smoke to create its own cached versions of the media. This step also applies to the conform process where you can choose how the footage is managed by Smoke as you rebuild your sequence. Just switch to the general tab and if cached source media is disabled, Smoke will work with the native media. If you enable this option, Smoke will transcode the imported media for the sequence for optimized performance. In this case, I want to work with the native media, so I'll ensure the option is turned off. Now switch to the Sequence Import Options tab. There are two search mechanisms that Smoke uses to find media when you import an AAF or XML: absolute searching and relative searching. The absolute search performs a scan inside the XML or AAF. The XML and AAF formats store the imported location of the media file on your system. So absolute scans always refer back to the original path of the media as per the XML or AAF. The relative search makes Smoke look at other folders and subfolders close to the AAF or XML location. So relative scans the surrounding folders for potential media to match the conform. So if you are on a different computer and the media is moved, the file paths will be different. This invalidates the absolute file paths in the XML or AAF. Therefore, you need to use the relative search to find the media. Just know that Smoke will always perform an absolute search, but you can disable relative searching if you want. However, it doesn't hurt to leave all the search options on in order to find the media in the initial search. The link to media files is always enabled by default as it builds the sequence that references the original media. The preferred media option is more specific to Avid Media Composer. Using original sources connects the AAF to the original files. Using the offline intermediates connects the AAF to the transcoded DNxHD files from the Avid Media Composer. Once your settings are ready, you can start the conform process and Smoke will rebuild the sequence and start looking for the media. You can monitor this process at the bottom left of your screen. Once the process is complete, you will see the sequence clip in the library folder, and there will also be a subfolder with all the sources used in the conformed sequence. If the sequence is not already open, double-click it to open it as the active sequence. The event list will populate itself with all the entries from the open sequence. You will notice that the status of each clip is linked, indicated by the chain icon. When you click on each entry, the positioner in the sequence will jump to that particular segment matching its source's entry. So you can verify each source has been found and the conform has been successful. Now you can switch to the Timeline tab and begin your work in Smoke. Please consult the Autodesk Help resources for the list of supported effects coming from AAF and XML sequences. In the next video, you will begin to organize your media and sequences in the media library to prepare for your edit.